In this lecture, we are going to be creating an array-based program where we are going to be initializing the array elements with an initializer list and accessing the array element. Remember, in the previous program that we did, we automatically initialized the array element. That is, we coded the program where the program will initialize the array element by itself with the value 0. Populate the array element with the value 0, but here we are going to initialize it by ourselves. All right, and to do so, let's look at the array we defined while we were trying to define the array in this particular PowerPoint point, where we have our C array -45 6. So let's create this array, initialize it, and then try to print it out on the terminal. So let's go back to the terminal. Let's declare the array C, and it's going to be contain 5 elements, and those elements are going to be let me go back again, going to be -45 60 -45 60 -45 60. So -45 60 72, and the last element. Let me see the last element. What is the last element? Sorry, the last element. The last element is 1543. 1543. So 1543. So I'll just come here. 1543. All right. This is the element. So creating and initializing an array. So we have created by initializing an array and initializing an array C. So here we are. Now the next thing that we are going to do, we are going to access each of the element of this array and then print it out on the terminal. So this is straightforward, as we did in the previous program. We make use of our for loop, and for, so we have our data size T, and then we say I equals to 0, and then I less than or equals to what, 4, because the last element, index of the last element is going to be 1 minus the size of the element minus 1. So it's going to be the 1 less than the size of the array. So the size of the array is 5. Now the last element is going to have an index of 4, and then we increment i, and then now we want to access the element. We just all right, so we want to print them out on the terminal. So element, all right, so before that, let's print the header, print out the header, print out the header, print out a header. So I'm going to have print format, where I'm going to have print out a header, where I'm going to have a index, and then element, element, value. And this particular index, this is the value that we have, or element. It's all the same thing. So, and then we have the conversion specifier here. Conversion specifier, format control string for s, and then for string is s, as we did last. We just have this 8s. So we have index, value is going to be printed out, and then we have a new line character. Now we want to be accessing the element and then print them out on the terminal. So we are going to have ZU, and then the element is going to be decimal integer. It's a decimal integer, 8. Let's go with 8 for now, or 12 as we did in the last program. and then we are going to have I, and then we have C I, and then after each printout, let's have a new line character, right? And then we have our sentiment terminator here. So now let's go and compile this program and run it and see. All right, so come here, we have GCC array 2, and I want to output it as array 2. So it has successfully compiled, that means there's not any error. So now let's run it and see. Array 2. So perfect, as we can see, dash for negative 45 60 72 1543. So this is how to create and initialize an array and be able to access the array elements one after the other and have it printed out on the terminal. Thank you for taking your time to watch my video tutorials.